Dominique Petit. Hi.
Yes. Hello. Hello.
So I just have 21 questions for you. Mm. Should we get started?
Okay, let's go.
So you started your dance career in New York, right?
I started in New York. Okay. I was 21.
Okay. Mm? Describe your time there in 3 words.
Oh, wow. It was mind-blowing, just intense, and very exciting.
Okay. How would you describe your choreographic style?
It's definitely expressive.
Okay.
Eclectic. And lyrical.
Okay. Who were your biggest choreographic influences?
Well, I always wanted to do things my way, you know, find my own way. So that's what I've been really mainly doing. But of course, working with Caroline Carson was, of course, a great influence.
Okay. How does the experience differ from being a dancer to being a choreographer?
When I dance, I really have to go deep inside, you know, mm-hmm. to dwell into my imagination. Whereas a choreographer, I am more looking at what I'm doing from the audience point of view.
Okay.
Okay, I have to go look.
What were your favorite 3 things about working in Paris?
Well, I had my own studio. That was fantastic.
Wow.
I had my own dance studios. And also, at the time, knowing, you know, I knew all the dancers in Paris. That was fantastic. That's 2, but...
Okay. Can you imagine a life without dance?
That's very difficult. Very difficult. I think I would have liked to be a clown, maybe.
Yeah. So what does the world look like without dance?
I think it'd be missing something essential.
Okay. Give us the top 3 highlights from your career so far.
Dancing at the Paris Opera.
Okay.
My first full evening solo in the Avignon Festival, and a piece I've made called Le Tournesol, which I'm proud of.
Okay. So do you have any tips for dancers who are trying to better themselves in improvisation?
Oh, yes. Be totally empty-minded. Okay. Talk to the space as a partner, and follow your intuition at the speed of light.
Okay. If you had to train in a different dance form now, what would you train in?
Buto.
Okay. How are you liking working in London?
I love the energy here. I love the energy, you know? And yes, and it's so alive, and I like that it's so cosmopolitan also.
Okay. So what do you miss most about home?
My kids, my garden, and the sun.
Ah, yeah. Explain what dance is to someone who has no idea what dance is.
Well, that's a great question. Dance is a state of being in which you are completely involved with movement so that you can feel an infinite varieties of and subtleness of emotions, and that makes it a language.
Okay, that's beautiful.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Explain what an artist is to you.
What?
An artist is to you.
An artist, I think it's an endless seeker of new ways to reflect and question the world we live in.
Okay. So how many languages do you speak?
4.
Give us a sentence in each.
Well, German. Komm doch mit mir. Etwas zu trinken. Spanish. Soy muy paciente de recibir noticias de mi amor. Et en français, les cerisiers sont en fleur en ce moment en France.
Okay. That's super impressive. I'm going to pretend like I know what you said. Have you learned anything brand new whilst working with Akram?
Yes, of course. You know, he has such articulate movement, hand gestures.
Okay.
And his rhythmic patterns are incredible.
Okay, so that's what you'd say those are then?
Yeah.
Okay. So you've presented solos all over the world.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Where was your favorite place?
Cuba, in Havana.
Oh, wow, okay.
In Cuba.
And for your final question, what's the best thing about being a dancer at 68?
It's exhausting, but it keeps me young. No, the best thing is that it enables me to be in contact with younger generation, you know, and the artistic point of view, and that's fantastic.
That's perfect. Well, thanks so much.
Bye, you guys.
Ciao.
Ciao.